More than 3 years after being indicted on charges of lying to a federal grand jury, the perjury case against famed baseball player Barry Bonds is nearing a close. The prosecution spent most of the morning presenting their closing arguments. They say the evidence proves it is, quote, implausible that Bonds did not know he was taking illegal performance-enhancing drugs and that he lied to a grand jury to preserve his reputation. Bonds testified at the 2003 Balco steroid trial that he never knowingly used banned drugs, only vitamins provided by his trainer, Greg Anderson.
But this case is not about steroids. It's not about whether Barry Bonds used steroids. It's about whether he knew he used steroids.
Much of the prosecution's evidence comes from a dozen witnesses, many who were granted immunity for their testimony. One was Bonds' former girlfriend who graphically described physical changes in the slugger. But the defense questioned her motives as a jaded lover.
I mean, a lot of these witnesses had an agenda involving Barry Bonds. There's really no doubt about that. The question is, are they all lying?
Bonds' defense team says the prosecution doesn't have enough evidence to make its case and rested yesterday without calling a single witness, including the home run king himself.
Barry Bonds' fate rests in the hands of 8 women and 4 men who will decide if the home run king knowingly tarnished his crown. In San Francisco, Danielle Lee, NBC News.